Today I'm working with my friend Kenya. Kenya, why don't you tell all of my viewers a little bit about yourself, where you're from, and what your background is.
I'm from Honduras. I'm also a makeup artist, and I'm Mathias' assistant.
Yes, I use Kenya a lot. She's one of my favorite assistants. And I'm going to show you how to take this Central American skin tone and kind of brighten it up and give you a new look for April 2014. For all you Latinas, Central Americans, and South American girls out there. Hope you enjoy. Okay, so the first thing I'm using on Kenya is an eyeshadow base from Sigma Cosmetics, and these are waterproof. This one is called Persuade. It's a very, very, very neutral, pale, taupey beige, and it works on almost all skin tones that are Caucasian or Latin American, unless they're very tan or very golden-y bronze. But this is a great eyeshadow base to start with. Next, I'm using the Sigma eyeshadow base for spring 2014 that I'm obsessed with from Sigma. It's called Neutralize. It's an amazing peachy gold shimmer, and it's going right on the lid. It's gonna really, really pop the eye, and I already know what colors I'm gonna be using second, third, and fourth, so this is a great base for those colors. Number 305 eyeshadow from Makeup Forever is one of my all-time favorites. It's like very, very deep cantaloupe gold, and there's a lot of shimmer, so I'm using it to pat on the eyelid alone and just really giving it a strong, vibrant finish. Another fantastic Makeup Forever shadow that I'm using on the inner corners is number 126. This is a taupey shimmer. It's not too white, it's not too gold, it's very neutral. It's almost taupey eggshell color, if you will. And I'm using this on the inner corner of Kenya's eyes. New for spring 2014, Sigma just came out with a new eyeshadow palette, which I love. It's called the Warm Neutral Palette, and I'm using this color right here, which is a deep bronze with gold flecks, and a little bit of this aubergine, which you'll see in just a few seconds, actually. This one's going on first. Senna has this fantastic contour kit, but it also has four shadows. It has a white, a bone, a taupe, and a brown. You can use these for brows. You can use them to contour darker skin tones. I'm using this one right now, which is like an eggshell ivory color, to highlight under Kenya's brow bone, just to kind of soften and lift the brow. This is a great product from Senna, which I love. This Eclipse eyeliner pencil from Sigma is fantastic. As you can see it going on, it's very, very, very dark and rich. I believe it's a coal liner, which is why it has so much pigment. And I'm using it right in the lash line, and then I'm using a brush to smudge it in. And that way I can kind of smudge and bring up into the outer corners, so then the next colors that I'm using will pop right on top. So I'm layering colors. You see, I use the eyeshadow base first, then I do the powder eyeshadow, then I do a little pencil coal liner, smudge that up so it becomes a second base, and then I put more shadow on top. So my technique of layering 3 to 4 different layers of product is how I get the eyes to stay all day long, and you should try. The number 600 lash is one of my go-to lashes. You'll have to subscribe and see the other lash that I absolutely love. But this one right here, number 600, is probably the first one I fell in love with. Okay, I'll just tell you now. The 747S is my number one go-to lash. This is my number two go-to lash, but it used to be my number one. Anyway, this is what I'm using on Kenya's eye right now, because everyone needs a lash. Now on Kenya's brow, I'm starting with a brow pencil. This is Mink Sketch-A-Brow from Senna. I love the pigment in this. It's very easy to glide on. I love the tiny, 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 tiny little point that it comes with. And on the other side, it actually has a little brow brush, so you can brush the little hairs in if you want. This is a fantastic pencil. This comes in 3 to 4 colors, so you should try. To fill in the center of the brow, because I don't want it as rich and dark as the outside and the tail, I'm using the Senna Brow Book, which is fantastic. And I'm using one of the lighter colors. As you can see, the top row is the lightest, middle row is the medium colors, and the bottom row are the darks and the grays. So I'm using this medium tip right over here. And that's what I'm using to fill in the middle of the hairs on Kenya's brows. All right, so as you can see, one of my tricks is to put mascara on the bottom lashes before I put any kind of pencil, and I'll tell you why. Because I'm using the eyeliner pencil Nutmeg from Sigma, and I wanted to smudge down under the roots of the lashes, but I want it to be even a little bit more waterproof than maybe it is on its own. So I'm using whatever little mascara gets on the skin, which stays wet for about 30 seconds before it dries. Once that pops on the skin just slightly, wherever I mess up just a little bit, I go in with the pencil, rub it in, and then smudge the pencil into the mascara. That creates a little bit more of a waterproof barrier in your lower lash line. To really open up Kenya's eyes, on the inner lower wet line, I'm using Senna's Eye Opener Pencil. This is a fantastic way to make the eyes look more awake, more vibrant, and larger than life. So you gotta get this little white pencil. White works too, but this is more of a bone. I don't know why I'm calling it white, because it's more of a bone color, more natural, more neutral. All right, and that's it. And that's a nice, beautiful, young, fresh spring 2014 look using cantaloupes, oranges, gold, pewters, browns, pinks on the cheeks. So it's just a nice, cool and warm mix together. I hope you enjoyed. Kenya, what do you think?
I love it. I love it all.
All right, you guys, that's it. I hope you enjoyed watching this spring 2014 quick tutorial for Latin olive skin tones. And if you have any suggestions as to what else I could be doing to help you along in your careers or to just point you in the right direction, ladies, if you're buying makeup for yourselves, just let me know down here in the comments box and I would love to reply to you. Also, remember to go to my website so you can see my work and read my bio if you want to know a little bit more about me. Follow me on Instagram at mathias4makeup. Follow me on Twitter at mathias4makeup. And find me on Facebook. All my links are at the end of the video and down below. Great, thanks for watching. Bye.